aluminum linoleum, aluminum linoleum.
Stranger, I haven't seen you in a while. Where have you been on the wall?
What's the deal?
Oh my gosh, you look great. Oh, it's been a while. I've been on tour.
Welcome, everyone. Welcome. Settle. Oh, thank you. You are all auditioning to live in a city environment. Those of you who move on today will have a shot at the ultimate glory, survival. You will be able to find food and shelter, and your offspring will carry on your genes long after you're gone. If you are not selected today, I'm sorry, your traits are just not what we're looking for, and you should leave this environment as soon as possible. And just have fun and support each other.
Competition. We've all done it, whether it's a soccer game or an audition. Humans are not the only animals that compete. Animals and plants here on Earth compete every day to survive and thrive. What plants and animals have you found in your neighborhood?
I've seen a bunny, spiders, birds, raccoons.
I see grass and trees,
a lot of pine trees.
Squirrels, I've seen daisies,
and there's a bunch of different kind of creatures around me.
Competition for food, shelter, and mates leads to adaptations, features that help a living thing survive. Every living thing has genes. Not genes, genes, the chemical building blocks of our bodies. Sometimes those genes make a misprint, like a typo, and that typo can code for a new feature. If that feature helps that living thing survive and reproduce, it can get passed to the next generation to help them thrive too. Like a pigeon. Pigeons are really well adapted to living in cities. Many years ago, pigeons, or rock doves, used to live on cliffs or ledges. Their ability and preference to nest in nooks and crannies means that in cities they can use ledges, stairwells, or the rain gutters of buildings as their own mini apartments, rent-free!
We're not gonna pay, we're not gonna pay, we're not gonna pay last year's
pay! Wild as it seems, the plants and animals that live in cities are especially adapted to living in harsh conditions, like lots of heat and not a lot of trees, and they depend on the city environment for survival. Ants thrive off the food and trash left behind by humans. The ants on New York City's Broadway can put away more than 1 ton of food scraps in less than a year. Ants rely on humans for that easy food source, and, well, in a way, humans rely on ants to dispose of our food waste. We may think of bugs as pests, but we depend on each other. Even animals we may not think of as cute or cuddly are wonderful examples of adaptations, like the cockroach. Cockroaches are incredible survivors. They're omnivores, which means they eat both plants and animals. Plus, they run super fast, and they can even grow back limbs.
Stop, flick, squish, oh, look down low, still here.
By building cities and impacting natural habitats, we humans have made environments in which some animals thrive. And others don't.
You know that feeling when you run out of syrup?
Next!
Experiment time! This experiment is based off the fieldwork of an entire family of biologists. Rosemary and Peter Grant and their daughters Nicola and Talia, who were 8 and 6 years old when they helped make scientific decisions with their family. The Grants studied a type of finch that lived on a small island in the Galapagos, and they noticed that the finch's beaks would change shape every few years, depending on the island's extreme and changing weather. For this experiment, you'll be playing the part of the finch. You'll need tongs, tweezers, big objects like ping pong balls or blocks, small objects like marbles or beads, a bin to hold it all together, a timer, something to write on, and something to write with. For round one, place the large objects in the bin. These objects represent your food. Yum! Grab your tongs. That's your beak. Set your timer for 30 seconds. Press go and try to collect as many objects out of the bin as you can. Count the objects and record them in your chart. For round two, use the tweezers as your beak instead of the tongs. Set your timer and go! For round three, place small objects in the bin and tongs as your beak. Set your timer for 30 seconds and go! Round four, small objects, tweezer beak. What did you observe, scientist? Which beak made it easier to pick up larger objects? Which beak worked well for smaller objects? Bird beaks range in size, and different beaks are good at picking up different types of food. The bird that can get the food passes on that beak size down to their babies. You can add to this experiment by trying different types of beaks, like spoons or chopsticks or butterfly nets, and different types of food, like rubber bands, cotton balls, or tiny eraser fruits. Get creative, little bird. Researching finches on isolated Galapagos islands sounds pretty amazing. We can also find adaptations in our own backyard, or sidewalk, or parking lot. A city can be your own beautiful, loud, stinky Galapagos. So take a look around and make some observations about the plants and animals that are your neighbors. What kinds of adaptations do they have? Take notes, make discoveries. Your community is a pretty cool place to start. What do you think, scientist?
So I just got back from a trip to the big city, and I gotta say, I really don't moose it. Everyone just moves so fast. They really miss the forest for the trees.